Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one, we're going to be looking at a field test of the last hand generator fix we did. Let's see how it goes. We are in Colombia, the top north part of South America, just after the skinny part, Panama, bordered by Venezuela, Ecuador and Peru and Brazil. We are on the third mountain range of the Andes mountain range in Bogota. We're going to go down the mountain range to Villavicencio. In the north, it's all grasslands. In from there south, it's all jungle. We're going to go to Villavicencio in another day and a half across the plains to the Department of Vichada. So it's 3 o'clock start, no, 3:30 start in the morning to take a bus down to Villavicencio. So off we go, see how the trip goes. It's now about 4:30 in the morning.
It takes 2 or 3 hours to get across the city, and then we go about 800 metres up to the top of the range, and then down the other side for 3 or 4 hours to Villavicencio. And going down to Villavicencio, we pass through 7 tunnels, dropping in altitude by about 2,500 to 3,000 metres.
First leg of the journey done to Villavicencio, and then we're going to head for at least a day out onto the plains.
We picked up another couple passengers in the city, then headed out. Then somewhere around Puerto Lopez, we heard some mechanical noises.
Turns out our gearbox started to fall off, so we're going to have to stop and fix that.
Having fixed that, we went past planted pine forests, acacia forests, rubber plantations, and sugarcane plantations until the tar seal ran out.
So after a day's travelling, a broken down vehicle, and things, we're right out of telephone range and getting out into the country halfway. Well, no, we passed halfway across the country. And time to sleep for the night.
So it's almost 6 o'clock in the morning, and we're getting ready to do the next leg of the journey, second day of travel.
Me dijeron que
no,
que el papá iba a venir.
Sí,
sí, van a mandar.
So off we go on the next part.
More flat and more flat, with the occasional oil rig poking up here and there, and also a very large palm oil plantation.
Happened.
The vegetation gets sparser and shorter. A few days ago it had rained, so it was starting to get all wet. The rainy season will be soon coming, and the roads will soon be impassable. We've passed the last little town in the department of Meta without stopping before heading on to the department of Vichada. We stopped at the first little town in Vichada, which actually had cell phone coverage, but I have no idea if there are any other towns around as we're getting into indigenous territory. The terrain was getting a little bit hillier, and the acidic soil means that very little except grass grows here. And this is where I'm going to be trying the hand generator in this community of the Piapoco tribe. We had a meeting and then some refreshments that we had brought, but we were going to head out again to visit some other communities around about.
Buenas tardes.
Jesús, yo te amo a ti.
1:20, ahí no está en el Nuevo Testamento.
Sí, él tiene, porque él tiene el Antiguo Testamento.
La Biblia dice.
Most of these communities in this area have no electricity whatsoever, so I'm interested to see how my hand generator is going to go. This small community lives in the structures that the government has built as a community meeting place for the tribes around here. So they actually have a petrol-powered generator. The last community was the largest of the ones that we visited. And as far as I know, it has no electricity at all. The sun went down and it was pitch dark. Fortunately, we had a good guide that managed to get us to the first place again so that I could try out the hand generator. So this is where I slept last night, and what were my conclusions so far? Now this family had a solar panel with one car battery with one headlamp bulb. This was supplemented by handheld battery-powered torches. They are disposable ones, not even rechargeables, and it's costing them a lot of money for their situation. They have to sell some of their hard-earned food, and it takes them a day to get to that town and back just to get some new batteries. Amazingly enough, they have cell phones and they charge those using a motorbike. My handheld generator has no onboard battery, so using it is a two-man operation. One will hold it and generate the light while another does their activity. They say this will still be useful and it will save them a lot on batteries. But we'll see how it goes over the next few months, and we'll also see how that belt fix is going to last out.